song, praise him, for he is thy health and salvation.
My soul, praise him, for he is thy health and salvation.
Oh. What a pleasure it is to hear you. And I have to tell you that I just wrote down, your balance is astonishing considering your numbers. You have worked so hard to make sure that everything is heard, even though we don't have equal numbers across the choir. And it's really great work. It's really, really great work. Congratulations, Hi. So I have an idea about the way that we're standing. Can I play with you a little bit? So will you three go up to the top row for me? Thank you. And will you two go up to the next, to the two rows? And will you two go up two rows? And will you two go up one row? Yeah. Good. And then spread out a little bit. Spread out. And maybe the last person on each section, will you stand on the floor? Will you stand on the floor?
Okay.
Who's our monster bass? Which one of you is the loud one? So do you know who Avi Kaplan is?
What?
Do you know who Avi Kaplan is?
No.
Okay, you guys know who Avi Kaplan is? He's the former bass of the Pentatonics. And he's got a very similar color to yours. It's just really open. We're so fortunate that we have that color because it gives us something to sing into, right? I just want to hear what it sounds like with him like this. I hear my prayer.
Yeah.
Will you start that for me?
Yeah, sure.
And I love your color on this. It's really beautiful, open, free singing. Can you start that for me? Remember that the conductor guides us, but we're not necessarily glued to the conductor. Especially with a group this small, you can look across each other, sing to each other, and sing with each other. Enjoy. Start. It's open and freer, right? Mm-hmm. The sense that I get is they can sing a little bit more. What I'd like to do is have you guys spread out even just a little bit more equally so that you can turn in a little bit. So that you two on the outside are almost looking at each other. And you guys are looking at each other and you're looking at each other. Does that make sense to you? I'm going to connect the same thing. Watching so closely as I mess with you. Good watching. I think you can take that much tech stress on this, you know, because they watch so well. Figure out what words are the most important to them and to you and to the song itself, and then sing that. Let's try one more thing. What part do you three sing?
Alto.
Soprano and alto. Loose soprano's over here, yeah? Mm-hmm. So let's do this. I'm just still playing with color because we have such a small group. I want to put you three up there, and you guys just move in either direction. So the three basses are going to be in the center. There you go. Now let's hear how this changes the color and changes the balance. Okay, we're good? One more time. What do you guys? think?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I always, I love a chamber, one of my favorite chamber choirs I ever had was 16 singers at Long Beach State. And it's like having a bunch of pro singers. Everybody matters when there's 16 of you. We always tell big choirs, everybody matters. But when there's 16 of you, guess what? Everybody matters. Or whatever you've got here, even more. Good. Let's take a look at the famine song, huh? I watched the Super Bowl with the composer of this piece last night with Matt. It was really fun, actually. He has an amazing sense of humor. He's one of the funniest people I've ever met. You don't know that in this song. There's not a lot of humor in this song. Basses, I always like to think of this as kind of, can I get a fresh E?
We did an E flat.
Oh, a fresh E flat is great. So kind of think of a little bit of coming up from underneath on it. So that little bit of an African, like, you know, think a little bit of Lion King in it on the hum. You know what I mean? Try it.
Hum.
Hum. Even faster slide.
Hum.
And can you relax your jaws when you get there? Hum. Yeah.
Hum.
So think of that kind of like, how much space can you give me in your chest as you come in there? Two, three, four. Not getting all the way down to the E flat, I guess. It should be in unison with the bass is when it comes to that moment. Basses, this is great to say. You guys are actually too loud. Once the women come in, it's too loud. You're in the background. You're the guys off hunting. They're the ones who are singing about the... So go away. Be in the next village. Once they come in. One, two, three, four. Tuning and perfect blend right there. What a pleasure it is to work with you guys. I wish I had another hour. So much fun. Thank you.
I've got 5 whole minutes with you guys. That's more than I've had with any other band. Excellent, excellent. Congratulations to you. There's lots of expressive music going on today. I think the 2 works are right in the pocket for them. You know, you seem confident with them. I want to explore a little bit of Rob Romaine's piece with you. Okay, so if you can, we can just stay on Apollo myth and legend, right? This is drama. How many of you have seen Robin Hood, the old movie from about 20, 25 years ago? This is Robin Hood's score. Michael Kamen, can you hear it in there? You know, it's that kind of energy about it. And I think that's a good way for us to think about it. I want to take you to a point, if I can find it here, 107, what was that? Yeah, 107. Can we take it right there, everybody? Let's just take note of what it feels like to be here with this music. I'll be a little bit different, perhaps, so bear with me. 2, 3, ah. Good. So this feels pretty cool right here, doesn't it? It says heroically, everybody's like, this. I mean, we hear that coming out. Can you take the confidence that you have right here and throw it back into the other sections of the piece that aren't tutti scoring? What we mean by that is everybody's playing. It feels, it's easier for us to be brave when everybody's in on it. But when it gets more thinly textured and so on, that same level of confidence that you feel right here needs to be happening there as well. And that's going to take your performance of this piece and just lift it. That's really nice. Yom patatim pom pidam. That second measure downbeat with the accent, that's the important note, isn't it? Lom patatim pom padam. That's where the line goes. Composers are lazy. We don't draw everything in. We hope that you sense it and try to make it happen. And as soon as you do, this piece, instead of sort of going along like this, starts to lean forward and it has a little bit of an attitude about it. And you can feel that here, can't you? And so now, you know, if we went back to the beginning of this bit, let's take a look, please, where it says menacing, 27. Okay, now where were we? We were just heroically, it's like we've just survived the menacing Apollo whatever is happening here, right? So here we go. And so you have that energy, 107 energy. 2, 3, ah. Good, good. So this needs to be a little bit more lightly tongued rather than heavily tongued so we don't lose time. Dum dum ta ta ti ta ta ti ta dum dum. Okay? Stay a little bit lighter with it. 2, 3, clean. Now, did I scare you? I'm amplified, right? But do you feel that? That, you know, it says menacingly in a ding. That's more fun, isn't it? And so that's the kind of energy that I would put there. Here's 39. If you have a hemiola where it's 3 against 2, put a little bit of separation so you don't lose time. 39, 2, ready, go. 2, 3. Za, ah, ah, ah. Maybe some separation. Good, good. My challenge to you is to go find the old Robin Hood with Kevin Costner movie and watch it sometime. His British accent is pathetic, you know, but the sound score is fantastic, and you will hear where this piece came from. And then you'll get a little bit more idea of that kind of energy that we're talking about. Thank you. I appreciate working with you. Congratulations to you. Good luck with everything. Pleasure to hear your group.